In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of breathing muscles. Particularly, I want to focus on muscles that do exhalation. Exhalation means breathe out. Okay, for another video, I explained about inhalation muscles. Today is about exhalation. Let's get started. First, muscles are like abdominal muscles. First one is this one. This is external oblique. External oblique. And you don't see next muscle if there is external oblique. This should be internal. So next one is deep to external oblique. This is internal oblique. Internal oblique, okay? Next one is this one. This is famous six-pack muscle. This is rectus abdominis. Okay? Then last one is very thin muscle. This is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. This is very thin muscle. So this one doesn't do much exhalation compared to other three muscles. Think about it. External oblique, internal oblique, and rectus abdominis are strong ab muscles, right? When you contract these muscles, you can squeeze your abdominal area, right? That means they are so strong. But transverse abdominis is not that strong. That means this guy cannot do much exhalation compared to other three muscles. So maybe slight exhalation, okay? Transverse abdominis, very weak exhalation muscle. So these muscles act as exhalation muscle when you try to force to exhale. Okay, when you do weight training, when you do sports, it's like movement, holding breath movement. When such a moment, these abdominal muscles contract to exhale breathing. Okay, external oblique, internal oblique, rectus abdominis, and transverse abdominis is weak exhalation muscle. Let's go to next picture. Okay, next one is this one. This muscle is between ribs. This is internal intercostalis. Internal intercostalis. Okay, internal does exhalation. It's a little bit confusing. By the way, for another video, I said external intercostalis does inhalation. That is even more confusing, right? Internal intercostalis does exhalation. Okay, this is important thing. Okay, this is internal intercostalis. Next one is this one. This is deep to ribcage because costal cartilage is removed. This is minor and thin muscle. This is transverse thoracis. Transverse thoracis, okay? This is inside of ribcage. Next one is even more minor muscle, which is this one. You see this thin, long muscle? This is also inside of ribcage. This is subcostalis. Subcostalis is also inside of ribcage. Internal intercostalis is between ribcage. Transverse thoracis is inside of ribcage. And also subcostalis is inside of ribcage. They do exhalation as well. Now, last one from this picture is this one. This is quadratus lumborum. quad latus, lumborum. This is also an abdominal muscle. This guy attaches to 12th rib. 12th rib. Thus, when they contract, they bring ribcage this way. This is exhalation movement. Okay, quadratus lumborum. This is also abdominal muscle. Let's move on to next picture. This is backside of body. First muscle from this picture is this one. This is kind of a V-shaped muscle. This is serratus posterior inferior. Serratus posterior inferior. I explained serratus posterior superior from another video. That is also for inhalation muscle. But serratus posterior inferior is for exhalation. When this muscle contracts, vector is going this way, going down. That means this muscle kind of squeezes ribcage. When ribcage is squeezed, that is when exhalation is going on. Okay, serratus posterior inferior, very minor muscle, however, very important. Next one is kind of a group of muscle, erector spinae, particularly iliocostalis and longissimus. Iliocostalis and longissimus, particularly on lower part, because the upper part of erector spinae don't attach to ribcage. So it's like this area, lumbar area and thorax area. The primary function of these guys are, of course, extension of trunk, extension of spines. But when they contract, vector force is going this way. This vector also squeezes ribcage. Now, acceleration is going on. As I said from first picture, do you remember these abdominal muscles? I said when you try to force to exhale, these muscles contract. It's like when you force to put extra force, like during weight training, right? Same as abdominal muscles. These back muscles also contract when you try to force exhale, okay? So exhalation muscles are not working during natural breathing. These muscles act as exhalation muscle when you try to exhale kind of strongly, okay? But they are so important to stabilize ribcage and abdominal area, then exhalation happens. Okay, this is very important to understand. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.